We have the Cartels, and this is a song called Higher. We've got Aiden here on guitar. We've got Dean on drums. And we've got Rob on bass. This is a song called Glory.
Circus TV. I'm here with Owen from the Holy Sparks. We're gonna have a quick chat about their music. So you're obviously two guys short.
We are, unfortunately.
Missing Ken and Dara tonight.
A couple of people missing in action this evening, but yeah.
It is what it is.
It is what it is. Yeah. These things happen.
So tell me, how long have you guys been together?
We've been together a little over 2 years.
Two years.
At this age, yeah.
Very good. And who would your influences be?
It's fairly wide ranging, I would have to say. I mean, it would be hard to pinpoint what exactly we have in common, to be honest with you. But I think it just works very well because we tend to kind of write songs collectively just through jamming, and I think a lot of things get mixed in together.
Right.
I know that's a very political answer to that question, but it's hard to say exactly. Like, I mean, I don't know. I'm into everything from kind of electronica to kind of rockabilly and stuff. Like Ken would be more into kind of classic rock, I guess, and Dara's a bit more of an indie kid. And,
right.
But it all just kind of gets mushed up.
So good eclectic sound.
Good, yeah. Kind of comes out sounding like some sort of a, I don't know, garage prog rock space rock mess, you know. So
with so many different aspects of you guys, how'd you meet?
Myself and Ken were in another band that kind of finished up for various reasons before it got going, and then we just stuck up an ad looking for Dara, you know.
Oh,
that's kind of happened. We didn't know one another beforehand, so luckily enough we all got on quite well. So
right, so you guys have been gigging away and recording.
We have the past few months have been pretty quiet on the gigging front because we've been working on an album, so which is done to all intents and purposes now, so just we just have to kind of get it together, hopefully get that out sometime in maybe April.
Brilliant.
So we're nearly there.
This is the new album coming out in April, mm-hmm. and then you've already got an EP that people
we've
can
got an EP
to?
Plots of the Patriarchs, yeah. That's, you get that from our Bandcamp, or from, we're involved in another kind of collective / label / whatever you want to make it called, Drunken Lust Records.
Right.
So it's also available from there.
So where do people, what's the URL for that?
Just put Drunken Lust Records and you'll actually go to the website as opposed to just Drunken Lust, which will bring you to other websites. But I go to the band website and then you can navigate from there to the...
Very good.
Yeah.
So tell me, where did the name come from?
Holy Sparks or Drunken Lust Records? Holy Sparks. Well, Drunken Lust Records is pretty obvious. I used to promote gigs, and I used to run a night called An Evening of Drunken Lust. So that's where that came from. From the Holy Sparks. Despite its kind of mystical kind of connotations, it actually came from when we started first. Our first batch of demos we put up, we were using a kind of a working title for the band, which was a pretty awful name. The Catastrophites.
Oh, wow.
Pretty bad. And the feedback was like, the music's great, but the name's awful. So we did over a Friday via text. We were meeting up in the evening for a few pints anyway. I was doing this almost kind of a word association thing, like the red lights, the red sparks, you know, the holy this, the holy that, and then the Holy Sparks kind of fell out. And I knew I had read or I was aware of it from something else, and it just kind of sounded right. And the other two guys liked it, and yeah, so there you go. So there's the decidedly unmystical. Well, maybe I suppose
the Holy Sparks
from kind of,
were born.
It came from the collective unconscious or something.
Yeah.
You know, something.
Great.
Yeah.
So you've got gigs coming up.
We don't have anything in the pipeline just yet. We'll be hopefully putting together a launch gig in April, and we'll probably have a few kind of small gigs, you know, support slots and stuff like that, and the run-up to that all going well.
Would you be testing out any of the new tunes?
We were playing gigs last Sunday, so, and we threw in a few of the new ones, but most of the stuff on the album isn't that new per se. Like, we've been we tend to be fairly prolific, so I think nearly every time we play we're introducing something new, so.
Great. Well, thanks very much,
okay,
Owen.
Great.
This is Owen from the Holy Sparks. You look out for their Bandcamp and download their EP, and keep an eye out for them in April for their new album. Thanks for watching Night Circus TV.
5, 6, 7, 8. We'll be right back. Thank you.
This song's called The Skeleton Ladies of Baggot Street.
Thank you. is Night Circus TV, and we are today, or tonight, with these guys, and they are the Marians. Woo! Yay! Welcome, guys. Well, first of all, I introduce myself. Let's introduce you. Can you do that by yourself?
Yeah.
Yeah, what's your name?
My name's Eamon.
Eamon. I'm Lisa.
I'm Joe.
I'm Gerald.
And I was checking some information there that you have on Facebook. That would be nice also to remember the people who is watching us was the Facebook name page. And also, I saw that you are recording an EP.
Okay, yeah, well, we have very good intentions of recording our EP. We're working on our EP at the minute, so we're writing for it. And we hope to get into record in the next maybe 3 or 4 months, so hopefully we should have something tangible come summertime.
Cool. Do you guys have already the 4 songs that are going to that EP, or?
We haven't really decided yet. We're just going to keep working on what we have and then pick kind of the 4 best that we think will sound the best on the EP, you know?
Yeah, sure. And somebody who never listened your music before, how would you describe what is Marians?
If I could sum it up in one word, I'd have to say brilliant.
Amazing.
I don't know really how to describe it. I don't think we can describe it ourselves yet, to be honest. We're still quite new, I suppose, in terms of our development. We met about 2 years ago and had no prior knowledge of each other. Well, the lads did, but I didn't know them. So I think probably in the last year or so, we're kind of coming into our own and finding our feet in terms of our writing and our style and stuff. I suppose maybe it's grounded in folk and rock roots. We all kind of bring something different to the table, so maybe some blues as well, depending on what track you're listening to. So it's a bit of a mishmash, you know. I suppose we don't really know how to describe it yet, so a lot of times the listener will do that for us.
All right.
I suppose primarily folk and rock.
Great. And who is Marianne? Is any girl called Marianne here?
I'm
or?
Yeah, this is Marianne.
He's Marianne.
No, the Marians, you want to explain that one, Emma?
Yeah, it just came, we kind of wanted like a sort of a feminine name for the band, like, just so it didn't sound like a hard rock band, kind of, so. My niece is called Marianne, and I always thought it was a nice name, so I was listening to that song, the Leonard Cohen song, So Long Marianne, so I just thought Marianne would be a nice name to go with, and we just kind of decided on the Marians.
Good name,
so, yeah,
good,
that's
good.
Very much.
You talk about writing songs. Who is the one who is in charge? Everybody do some collaboration with that, or how is that process for whoever does it?
I suppose it is kind of collaborative in ways. We all give input. We're a bit of a democracy, really. In terms of lyrics and stuff, to date, I suppose I've kind of looked after those. But we kind of build songs up in different ways, so maybe sometimes I might come to the guys with an idea, you know, and we build up from there, or sometimes they might have an idea in terms of, you know, progression or music, and then, you know, we'll start working on the melody and the lyrics after that. So, yeah, it's collaborative and interesting, and there's always lots of dialogue and heated discussion involved.
That's good. It's also like you guys before were telling me about instruments. So many instruments in the band, never is enough.
Jeez. But it's a good feel, yeah.
Is it?
Yeah, well, we have the basics, like we have, like Joe's on guitar, mostly lead, Lisa plays rhythm, Rob plays piano mostly, I'm on the bass, and we have a drum kit as well. But now and then the lads would switch between, like, say, banjo and mandolin too, you know, and there's some tin whistle going on as well. And, so there's a good few instruments going on. Whatever the song needs, really, we just kind of throw them in, you know?
Yeah, I actually like that one with the tin whistle. And I think that's the song, what's the name of that song?
The Cross.
The Cross. That song is the one who is involved with some charity stuff. Was that song?
No, it's
Home,
it's
sorry.
Home.
Home. Okay, let's talk about home first and then about the other one.
Okay.
Okay. How was that process like? It's not easy to be part of, like, should be easy to be part of some collaboration or charity, but sometimes, like now in these days, like it's very difficult to get into even a gig or event. So how do you guys make that possible?
Yeah, I suppose that was kind of our first kind of big gig, actually, that charity gig. I was doing some work at the time with the Refugee Council, the Irish Refugee Council, and they were hosting a charity event, and I thought it'd be, you know, kind of appropriate to write a song, kind of based, I suppose, largely on the work that I was doing with young people who were seeking asylum here. So we wrote the song Home, and that's obviously what it's about. And we were lucky enough then to perform at the village for the charity gig, and we got to play with some great bands. So it was great, you know, we got, I think, more out of it, really, to be honest, yeah, than, you know, than they did. So whatever money that we had made from the sales, it was available to download online, it all went to them. So we managed to raise a bit of cash for them, so it was worthwhile.
Good. About this downloading now, it's like difficult with musicians and in general artists. Everything you can get for free in the internet, everything you can just, I don't know, even sometimes steal it.
Yeah.
So will you put your music for free after you finish your EP? Was the idea to do an EP? I don't know. Could you tell me something?
You know, I always thought like new bands start charging a tenner for stuff you've never heard before. I never really agreed with that. Like, I don't think we should ever charge for any of our initial music. Like, or, you know, just give it a good, like, reason to be online. Like, why not, like, write a song for charity and stuff, you know? Like, it's just about getting your music out there and writing the music. Like, it's I don't agree with the money thing anyways. At least it could be different now, but...
I think,
well, sometimes
course,
money,
Look, helps. I mean, at the minute, when you're starting out and you're trying to, you know, find your feet, I think you're happy if anybody wants to listen to your music at all. You know, you'll play to anybody, you'll play to an audience of one, you know. You don't really care who's downloading it or who's purchasing it. I mean, obviously, when you're going into recording an EP or an album, you're investing and you would like to see money, you know, some of that money back eventually, but it's not a priority for us right now. I mean, we know that we have I suppose quite a big financial investment in terms of our recording, you know, to come, and whether or not we see that back again is irrelevant right now, you know. It would be nice to see it back, but it's certainly not, it's not something that we're thinking of, you know. We just, you know, we want to write it for ourselves and to, you know, have a piece of work that we can be proud of and that hopefully, you know, listeners will respond to. And I suppose at the minute that's all we could ask for.
Good. And the goal for 2014 for you guys?
The Grammys, I think.
I think it's just to work on the EP. I think it's the next stage. I'd like to get that out there in 2014. So.
And play a few festivals too.
Yeah. I would say we were in the studio there for a while writing, so we'd like to polish up what we have and bring it out and play some gigs and sort of get the name out there.
Just to get maybe one solid piece of work that we can keep gigging with, like instead of going back to the studio and then back gigging. And just, it'd be nice just because we've put in so many months writing and stuff, it'd be nice just to play for like 6 months and then get back to writing, you know, just get the album out, I guess, you know?
Yeah, it's actually the season to send demos to festivals.
Yeah.
Do you guys send any?
Yeah, we're looking to apply for like Knockin' Stockin' and stuff like that, you know, so we'll just apply for whatever ones we can find really, and hopefully we get something from there, you know?
Yeah, hopefully.
We did send a few demos, all right, you know, like, demos are, sometimes they listen, obviously, sometimes they don't, you know, but we're more focused this year now. I mean, last year, like, we hadn't been together really, you know, not even 2 full years, you know, this is the end of our second year together, so we are focused on, we've spent a lot of time rehearsing, we obviously want to do that over the next few weeks anyway, and then maybe get the EP in March or April time, and then we'll be kind of set on gigging, and hopefully, you know, we'll get to play a couple of festivals wherever they are or whatever they are.
Good.
For interviewing us here in this lovely area.
Yeah, thanks so much. And I think, Joe, it's very cold. You're very far away. Let's give us a group hug. And then in this way, we say goodbye.
And then we'll go on the swings and fly.
I'll see you later.
We're the Mariannes. This is Mama Please.
Mama Please, can you help me? I never asked for much. I'm in need of a favor. I just ran out of
I'm not afraid to Hello, we're the Mariannes, and this is God-Fearing Woman.
Jack here behind me, Eamon on bass, Joe on lead, Grod over there on guitar, and Ian at the back of the drums. And this song's called By Your Feet.